Hi and welcome back. I'm really excited about today's topic and I'm very much looking forward to hear your opinions on this, so please don't forget to comment after having watched this video. Revit 2022 gave us a lot of new features and a very exciting one are the shared parameters in key schedules. I know this touches a couple of topics not everyone might be familiar with, so I will first explain briefly what shared parameters are, then we will have a look at how we can create the key schedules in Revit, and at the end I will share some ideas with you how we can use these key schedules to drive the IFC shared parameters. So let's get started. The shared parameters in Revit are the most powerful kind of parameters because they cannot be only scheduled and tagged, but they are stored outside of the Revit project and therefore are consistent throughout all of the projects and families you use them in, and they can also be accessed from other databases. Whenever you are creating a new project parameter, you can choose between creating a regular one or a shared one. You should use a regular one only if you're sure that you won't need to tag this parameter later on. Otherwise, you should rather create a shared one, which will be then stored in a separate text file and which you will also be able to use in other families and projects. By referencing this text file later, you can browse your already created shared parameters and add them to the projects and families. This is also what is recommended for adding the IFC parameters to Revit, as the Revit IFC ships with an own shared parameter file where you already have all the available parameters defined and you don't need to worry about the correct naming or the data type. You just pick them from the list and add them to the categories as needed. The Revit IFC ships with two shared parameter files. One is meant for the instance parameters in Revit and the other one for the type parameters. The reason for this is that in IFC, the values on the type and on the instance level can be different. However, when using key schedules, we can only use the instance parameters anyway, so we won't dig deeper into this now. This might be a good topic for a future video. By the way, if you want to learn more about the shared parameters or also other types of parameters in Revit, there is a great video by the Aussie BIM Guru, which I will link in the video description below. So now that we know what the shared parameters are, let's have a look at how we can use them in key schedules. The key schedule are a special kind of schedules in Revit because they allow you to drive multiple properties by selecting one key schedule. To create a key schedule, just select Create New Schedule and switch from the regular schedule, which is selected by default, to Key Schedule. Here you need to enter a name for your key and go ahead to select the properties you want to include in your list. Before Revit 2022, you could not select the shared parameters here, and therefore the key schedules could not be used in many situations. For example, also not for driving the IFC shared parameters. Once you have added the properties, you can start creating new lines and populating the values. As you can see, it is quite simple to create a key schedule. Now let's have a look how we can use it for the IFC shared parameters. I have already created a key schedule here and I have added all the IFC parameters previously to the project as shared parameters. The probably most used IFC parameter is IFC Export As, which lets you select an alternative IFC class and type on the element level. To remind you, we have the global settings for the mapping of Revit categories to classes in the IFC export settings. However, IFC has a more granular classification for certain elements, so we often need to override this mapping on the element level. For example, here I have two slab elements, where one is the structural slab and the other one is the floor covering in this specific room. If we have a look at the IFC documentation, you can see that we have different slab types defined, which you can also enter in the IFC export as parameter after the class and separated by a dot. Also in the IFC documentation, you can find a separate class called IFC covering, which again has different types for all the possible coverings. To use these in Revit, you typically need to copy and paste them in Revit. However, you can also include them in the key schedule along with any other parameter you need. I have selected a couple of them here as well, just to show you how this works. Once the key schedule has been populated, you can simply use the key property in Revit to select the element type, and you don't need to worry about the correct IFC class and so on anymore. This is also very useful if you are using Revit in German or French, for example. You can choose the names for your keys freely and make them understandable for your Revit users. You can also notice that as soon as you select a key, the values which are driven by this key are grayed out and therefore cannot be edited manually anymore. In my opinion, the key schedules are incredibly powerful, and with the shared parameter support, they just got a brand new superpower. What's your opinion on this, and how are you intending to use the key schedules? Please share your ideas in the comments, and see you in the next video.